friends, how's it going? It's me, Betty Jean. Today I wanted to sit down and chat about my fall makeup favorites. I always do a fall one. I think I've done a fall makeup favorites like every year the last 3 or 4 years. I started doing it more seasonally as well, but I always look forward to doing the fall makeup favorites just because I love these cozy vibes. I love the autumnal tones. I feel like this is where grungy looks thrive the most. Very up my alley. I love these colors and I love doing this video. This is definitely more so geared towards eyeshadow palettes and lip products, but I do have some like liquid shadows, glitters, eye pencils, a few highlights, blushes, things like that that I wanted to share with you as well. Before we get started, I definitely don't think there's a rule that you have to wear your makeup seasonally. I think that's crazy. Literally wear whatever you want, whenever you want. I'll probably still rock a hot pink eye at some point this season. So literally wear whatever you want. There's no rules to makeup. I definitely feel compelled to use these more this time of year just because the colors are everywhere and it helps me feel more in the spirit. I feel like these types of videos almost encourage me more to have like a very big shop my stash to work on for the entire month. It helps me feel very into the season. It helps me get excited for what's to come. And it also just re-inspires me to use some makeup that I already had kicking around in my collection. As most of you know, I'm not really buying makeup right now. I just have many more life priorities that makeup is just not the first thing I want to spend money on at the moment. So this just really excites me and re-inspires me to use what I have and help me feel like just because it's old doesn't mean I shouldn't use it kind of thing. I feel like sometimes we get stuck in this mentality where we always have to have something new, and that's absolutely not the case. It is so much fun to shop our stashes and actually get use out of the things we spent our hard-earned money on, so I encourage you to shop your stash as well. Maybe sit down with your makeup collection, whether it be big or small, and just make a nice curated little selection of things that you're picking that you want to use for the autumn season. Before we hop into it, I did film this look, of course. I was just going for a soft, cozy, autumnal look. It should already be up on my Instagram by the time this video goes up. This wig, I believe, is just from a local wig shop, so I don't like know anything about it. I don't know the brand or anything off the top of my head. I also don't know the brand of this beanie. It's just a slouchy mustard beanie. I think I got all that out of the way. Let's just hop into it and chat about my fall makeup favorites. Like I sort of touched on in the beginning, I'm not really gonna talk about complexion products. There aren't really specific primers, foundations, concealers, bronzers, things like that that I reach for in the fall months. Summer and springtime, yes, I tend to use lighter coverage or no coverage things, but in the fall, sometimes I do no coverage, sometimes I do medium coverage. I just kind of vary it day by day based on what I want to use. I don't really have specific favorites. So let's just move right along. I do have a couple cream products to talk about before we get into powders. I have two cream blushes here to talk about. I have the Milani Cheek Kiss Blush in the shade Nude Flush. It's a really pretty, just warm, neutral kind of tone. I'll swatch as many things as I can for you. But just like a really pretty, warm, neutral kind of color. It's really, really pretty. I feel like this just goes with those warm fall vibes really nicely. The other one I have is a Glossier Cloud Paint. This is in the shade Dawn. It's a really pretty bright orange, like a little goes a very long way. I'm pretty sure I also put this shade in my summer favorites, but I feel like when pairing this with really pretty deepened orange eyeshadow looks or even a deeper orange blush or a lip product, I feel like it can all just melt together nicely. Dark greens would pair really nice with this as well. I really like this color and I just really like the formula as well. I don't really have specific cream highlights to share with you that are fall specific in my opinion, so let's just move on to powder. Again, I don't really have bronzers to share with you. I only have like 3 bronzers, so I just kind of interchange all of them year round. I don't really have a preference. I'm not even really wearing a ton of bronzer today. I just have a little bit of cream, so that's irrelevant for this video. But let's move on to powder blush. I have 3 specific things to share with you. First is this e.l.f. Bite Size Face Duo. This is in the shade Spiced Apple. I personally can't use the highlight shade because it's a little too deep for me, but if you're more of a medium skin tone, this would be such a perfect, just all-encompassing duo for you. But this blush is so fall. It's just the prettiest warm terracotta neutral color. Look how pretty that is. I feel like these almost have a little bit of a sheen to them, but not so much that I would consider these overly glowy. Just gonna build the swatch up a little more. It does allow my glowy products to kind of shine through underneath. It's just such a beautiful color. I love this little duo. It's my favorite one of the 3 that I own. The next 2 blush items are blush palettes. The first one is the Likely Makeup Clown Blush Palette. 99% sure I talked about this in last year's fall favorites as well. It's just perfect fall tones for the face, specifically for me, the orange and the yellow. I really like mixing the 2 together. It makes just the most beautiful, just warm, orangey yumminess. It's so, so cute. I'll swatch those 2 shades in particular. This whole palette is bomb, but I reach for these shades so much this time of year. These blushes are also insanely pigmented. I've totally used them as eyeshadows before. It works out nicely. They're so cute though. I love these blushes. Even just popping a little bit of the yellow just kind of in your temple zone, kind of haloing around your eye, and then having more of that orange draping everywhere else on your cheeks. Such a beautiful combination. I love it. As a lot of you know, I'm not a huge orange eyeshadow person, but I do love an orange blush. I think it's so flattering and beautiful on so many people. And the last blush palette I have to talk about today is the Juvia's Place Saharan 2. It's actually what I'm wearing today. My favorite combination in particular this time of year is mixing this kind of brown with the orange. That's the combination I have on my cheeks right now. I just think it's really pretty, just a nice, warm, cozy, neutrally orange kind of tone. It's not overly orange like the Likely Makeup palette. It's a lot more tamed down, but still warm and orange at the same time. Don't know if that makes sense, but it's super cute. I'll swatch those two shades for you just so you can see the layout. But as you can see, it's just a totally different tone of orange, and I feel like when this one's blended out, it's not quite as pigmented as the Likely Makeup ones. Very beautiful. I just love this arrangement of blush for the fall. I think it's perfect in my opinion. Next, let's talk about highlight. I have two singles and one palette to share with you. Highlight, I kind of feel the same way as all of my complexion products. I'll still wear kind of whatever I want whenever I want, but when I do want a specific autumnal feel, I feel like these ones are the ones I'm going to be reaching for. My first two are from Kaleidos. We have Ray Rider and Laser Glazer. It breaks my heart because Laser Glazer is no longer available, and I hate that because I know some of you still wanted it. It's a really cool green highlight, and I feel like it actually works really nice on the skin, even being as pale as myself. It's just so cool. It has the coolest green shift through it. And I feel like if you're going for very spooky green autumnal vibes, this would be such a cool pairing. I love this highlight. It also looks really pretty on the eyes as an eye topper. Such a good one. Kaleidos, I don't know why you thought you should get rid of this highlight, but you need to bring it back. Pronto, please. And next is Ray Rider. I mostly brought this out just to showcase the fact that I really enjoy champagne-y toned highlights this time of year, more so than any other time. I feel like it just kind of flatters those orangey highlights I like to use. It flatters pretty much any of those autumnal vibes. It's obviously nothing that revolutionary. It's a champagne-y highlight. It's glowy, it's light, nothing crazy, but I do prefer to pair more of these toned down, neutrally toned highlights this time of year, whereas spring and summer and winter, I go for blues and pinks and things like that. So that's why I wanted to explain this one. And last, I have the Odin's Eye Alva 2 highlight palette, specifically because of the shade Gnome. I'm wearing it on my cheekbones today. This is the most beautiful golden, almost orangey, but in a very like lightened way. It's so pretty with these orange blushes. I mean, I'm just loving the way my cheeks look. I've been doing this specific combination with that Juvia's Place palette and this Gnome highlight for like a week and a half now. I literally can't stop. This whole highlight palette in particular though is bomb, by the way. I reach for all the shades, but I've just been loving Gnome, and I didn't think I would be that excited about this color because again, it's just kind of another champagne-y one. You can see it's a lot warmer than the Ray Rider one. Ray Rider actually looks a little pinky in comparison. This one just has the coolest orangey gold shift. I'm obsessed with it. I think it flatters my blush picks so nicely. I do have a discount code with Odin's Eye. It's BeauteBean in all caps if you want to save 10%. Don't feel pressured to use it. I will make a commission and I appreciate it very much if you use it, but don't feel pressured. Only shop if you feel the need to. Ugh, I just love these highlights. This would be a fun little trio. Nobody would buy that trio except for me, but it's really cute. Okay, let's move on to one of the most exciting parts, eyeshadow palettes. I think I have 10 here. 10 plus an honorable mention, so let's get through these. The first one I picked is my Orb of Light Full Moon palette. Pretty sure this has been in my fall makeup favorites the last like 3 or so years. It's my personal favorite unconventional neutral palette. It has all those staple neutrals that you would want when you're doing just like really glam neutral looks, but it also has the pop of the mustard yellow, this kind of rusty orange, that deepened red. It's really pretty. It's an all matte palette, so you can just kind of pair whatever shimmers in your collection you feel like. I've loved every single look I've ever created with this. This is one of my favorite blacks in my collection. I just think it's such a fantastic little palette. I haven't pulled this out in a while, and I'm really excited to play with it this season. I'll probably use this in a get ready with me coming up. Next up, let's talk about some greens. I have my Kaleidos Makeup Sci-Fi Green Palette. It wouldn't be autumn if we weren't talking about grungy greens, right? This is such a perfect grungy green little color story. 6 pans, 4 mattes, 2 shimmers. Definitely leaning on that dingy green side. We also have a beautiful mustard yellow. We have 2 shimmers here, one leaning a little more on that green side, one a little more on the gold. We have a wonderful black. This black is fantastic as well to help deepen up your looks and make them really dramatic. I think this is such a fantastic palette from them. I'm really excited about this one, especially for this time of year. Again, I'll probably pull it out for a get ready with me. I'll probably pull all of these out throughout the season for my Shop My Stash, as that's my goal, is to use all of these, either in a Shop My Stash or an Instagram video, so stay tuned. Next, my perfect favorite, most lovely fall palette ever. This is the Classical Paradise from Ace Beauté. It is just an autumn lover's dream. We have those perfect deepened reds, that really cute orange, and even though I don't like orange eyeshadow, this one I can get down with because it pairs perfect with everything else. We have this nice grungy chartreusey olivey color. It's so cute. Beautiful yellow, a nice yellow shimmer. Lovely shimmers to complement all of these mattes. I live for this palette. I think it's so lovely and yummy. Literally perfect this time of year. I can't get enough of it. I get so excited talking about these color stories. Next up, probably my second favorite grungy autumnal palette, the Gemini palette from Melt Cosmetics. This was a subscriber gift a couple years ago, and I'm still so eternally grateful. This is what opened the door to Melt Cosmetics for me. This was my first ever product from them, and I'm so obsessed now. I love this palette. This is also one of my favorite blacks in my collection. Mostly mattes, 2 beautiful shimmers. I love because you can play with more of that grungy yellowy brown side. You can pop on over to the grungy greens. It's such a fantastic, beautiful palette. I love the formula. I love every look I've ever created with this. So perfect this time of year. It's too good. Next, I grabbed this one from Spoiled Lips Cosmetics. This is the Slay for Salma palette. It's such a cute little 9 pan. Every time I hold this little palette up, someone always tells me it reminds them of that Jackie Ina palette, and I can definitely see that with the purple and that green color. I just think this is such a cute little fall-themed color story. We have the purple, that deepened reddish cranberry color, this beautiful green shimmer. It's so metallic and pretty. We have these nice warm neutrals that can just give you that very cozy fall feel. There's also those pops of like pinky tones, which keep it a little interesting, but I feel like they're the right shade that they go perfect with these fall tones and would still allow you to create a very fall look. I think it's super cute. I love this. Next up, my Lime Crime Venus 2. I'm pretty sure this has also pretty much always been in my fall makeup favorites. Such a cute little 8 pan. This is actually my only Lime Crime palette I still have. I decluttered my other 2. I think I had 2. It's just the most perfect fall tones. That beautiful mustard, that olive green. I actually love the pop of light blue in here. I actually think it goes with it really nicely while also adding a nice contrast. This black isn't my favorite, but it does enough of a job to kind of deepen things up. It's a very cute little color story. I actually want to use this in my next Shop My Stash, so stay tuned for that because that will be hopefully soon, if not already up by the time this video is going up. I don't know when this video is going up, so this could already be up on my channel. Go check it out. Next up, talking about greens again, we have the Give Me Glow Juicy Olive. I feel like I couldn't talk about just one of my green palettes without talking about the other. They're both so beautiful in their own way. They have different tones going on. I feel like you don't need both, but I'm happy I have both, if that makes sense. This was also a subscriber gift, and I'm so thankful for it. It's so beautiful. Give Me Glow has one of my favorite formulas. The mattes are so pigmented and blendable. These shimmers are so wet and metallic. You can just have all the grungy green joy with this palette. It's fantastic. Speaking of grunge, my next pick is the Give Me Glow Grunge palette. This one is so beautiful. Another kind of unconventional neutral palette. This is very fall to me because we have like the deepened brown, the black. This dark purple is very spooky and fall to me. I love this kind of burnt orange where it's not overly orange, but it definitely has that autumnal feel. I feel like this is a very good just kind of not fully fall palette, but definitely a little more on the spooky side. It's not completely just neutral. I love it. I think this is so good. I need to play with this again ASAP. It's so, so cute. This next one isn't necessarily autumnal themed, but I'm still gonna use it this time of year because it just, the theming is too perfect. This is the Moonspell palette from Lunar Beauty. This was Lunar Beauty's Halloween release last year, and I love it so much. It's this beautiful book-shaped palette. I have to hold it funky so I don't blind you with this packaging. But really, the colors on the inside, while they're not overly fall, there's definitely fall vibes in here. We have a lot of these grungy, dingy colors like these guys. These pretty neutrals in the center are very fall-esque to me. We have some pops of purple, so you can create really cool fall looks, but you can also play with some fun color. Again, there's no rules. You can play with whatever you want when you want, and I'll definitely be busting this out again this season. I love this palette. The theming is just too perfect to not. Last palette before we get to my honorable mention. This is my Alter Ego Artemis palette. It's a very large palette. This is definitely the largest palette in my collection as far as number of shades go. I wish it was smaller, but I know why it's so big, because it's duping the Metropolis, which also has a million shades in it, but it's very fall themed. We have so many fall colors in here, those grungy olives, those rusty oranges, even the blues in here I feel like have enough depth and the right tone to them that make them a little more fall-esque. We have some pops of red. The golds in here are a little more on the dingy, grungy side, which is perfect for this time of year. I really enjoy this palette. The shimmers are just as beautiful and metallic as ever. Alter Ego kills it with their shimmer formula. The mattes in here are different than their other mattes. These ones are more of a cream texture, and then they turn matte as you're using them. They're not like wet and liquidy, but they are a little more creamy. I feel like they do require a bit more to build up to get the intensity that you want, but they blend like such a dream. You just have to use a little more patience to build them up. I do have a discount code with Alter Ego as well. It's Butte Bean in all caps. Again, don't feel pressured. I do make a commission, which I appreciate very much, and you can save 10%, but again, don't feel pressured to spend money if you are not looking to. And finally, my honorable mention, I figured I would talk about the little palette I used today. This is a new palette I just got in the mail from Pixie. It's the Hazelnut Haze palette. They sent it in PR, and it's the cutest little autumnal palette. You can't do anything outrageous with this, in my opinion. It's definitely more of that everyday on-the-go kind of palette. This is more so an honorable mention just because this is my only time using it so far. I just filmed with it today for the first time, so can't tell you for sure how in love I am with it, but I do like the color story. I think it's cute, so I figured I would throw her in there. Let's talk about some liquid glitter eyeshadows really quick. I have two picks for this time of year. This first one is from Pop Beauty. It's called Crushed Copper. It's a really pretty, just coppery rose gold color. I feel like it complements a lot of those fall tones that I really like. Like, this would actually pair beautifully if I used the mattes in my green palettes. I think that would be a really cool contrast. Obviously, this isn't an overly fall color. You can kind of use this anytime, but I do feel like I want to try to use it this season. I think it'll be a nice little pairing with some of the eyeshadow palettes I picked. My camera just died, so I had to switch the battery out, so if things suddenly look shifted, that's why. The second one I have to talk about is from Stila. It's one of the shade Mysteri liquid eyeshadows. This one is in the shade Hypnotic. These are really cool because they're like duochrome liquid shadows. This one is awesome because it's a green-red one, which is literally so perfect this time of year. I haven't worn this in a really long time, but hopefully the shift will capture. It's the most brilliant, like, cranberry reddish pink into that green. It's a really cool shade. I can't wait to play with this soon. I think it'll be a nice little addition to this fall makeup roundup here. I have one loose shadow to talk about. This is from Sugar Pill. It's the Brick Toast one. This is a really pretty, also kind of greenish reddish shift, and then it has all these little multi-colored flecks in it. You see if you can see it on my finger at all there. I don't know how impressive that's gonna look on camera, but it's so pretty in real life. It has the prettiest shifts to it. I love that red flash in there, the multicolored sparkles. Again, I don't feel like this is overly fall in and of itself, but paired with all of those fall shadows that I shared with you, I think it's gonna be such a cool statement and go along with it flawlessly. I have three glitters to talk about. With glitter, you're not supposed to use it around your eye. Be very careful if you do. Glitter is more so meant to be used like on the face and body. I personally will use them on my eyes, but do as I say, not as I do. Be very careful. Don't use them on your eyes unless you want to risk it, basically. First one I have to share with you is the Apocalyptic Beauty All Hallows Eve Glitter. I did check their site. This is no longer available, but I figured I would still share it with you because it will be popping up in videos. I did already use this in an Instagram video. I can't really show you these without them spilling everywhere, but it's beautiful, multi-dimensional orange and yellow glitters with little black bats in it, and just, I love all the different shapes of orange and yellow in here. It's so fall and so cute. I think they're gonna be coming out with another Halloween collection this year, so stay tuned for that. I do have a discount code with Apocalyptic Beauty. I think it's Butte Bean in all caps. It's in the description box. It'll save you 15%. I don't make a commission off of that. I do get store credit, but I don't get like a commission, if that makes sense. But their site's really cool. They have fun glitters if you're a glitter kind of person, even if you just want cool glitters for crafts or nail art or things like that. This next one is from Shroud Cosmetics. This is the Love Light Glitter. It's a really pretty, it's hard to explain, and again, I can't really show you without spilling it everywhere, but it's a really cool red with like a yellowish green shift to it. Again, I feel like in and of itself, it could be considered more of like summery or springy. I'm putting it in the fall category right now just because I feel like, again, paired with a lot of the shadows that I picked, I feel like it'll add a nice statement and contrast while also really flowing with it nicely and giving me some really cool autumn vibes. Really like Shrouds glitters. Shrouds in particular are biodegradable. At this point in my life, I'm not really buying glitters that aren't biodegradable. I highly recommend you do the same. Not positive about Apocalyptic Beauty. I don't think they are. I've had my glitters from them for quite a long time though. Shrouds are biodegradable though, which is fantastic. And I do have a discount code with Shroud. It's BeautBean in all caps if you want to save 10%. Backtracking a little bit before I get onto the last glitter, talking about Shroud reminded me I forgot one of my favorite fall palettes. This is the Divinity. I love this palette. I used it in a Shop My Stash maybe 3 or 4 weeks ago at this point. So good. I love the mustard, the green, that kind of grayish navy color. I think it's really perfect. This darkened maroon shade. This is such a beautiful fall palette. This one is getting discontinued, so I recommend picking it up if this is something you're interested in. I don't know if these are going to be continued as singles or not. I have no idea off the top of my head, but this is getting discontinued just so you're aware. Again, you can use my discount code BeautBean if you want to save money, but no pressure. Don't spend money unless you're trying to. All right, finally, the last glitter. This was a subscriber gift recently. This is one of the Makeup Geek sparklers in the shade Supernova. I thought this might be perfect for this time of year because it's this really pretty, almost chartreusey gold color. I think this is gonna complement a lot of those palettes really well, so I'm excited to try this out. I've never used a Makeup Geek sparkler before. I've been having a lot of fun lately with colored winged liners, so I figured I would chat about three options that I'm gonna probably be using a lot this time of year. These are the Super Brow Pomades from KVD Vegan Beauty. These are meant to be brow pomade, but they are waterproof and they are eye safe. So I personally use these as liners a lot of the time. I do use them in my brows as well, but I use like the brown shades, not the colorful shades. I picked the shades Aubergine, which is a really pretty, just kind of plummy maroon color. Literally gonna be perfect with so many of these palettes. Scarlet, which is this brilliant red. I'm not even opening them because they look exactly the same as the cap. And this one called Roxy Purple. I think this pop of purple might complement a lot of the things I'm doing really nicely. I don't know. I think these will be fun picks for this season. I have a few eye pencils to share with you before we hop into lip products and then finish this up. First, I have this one from Melt Cosmetics. It's called Baked. It's a really pretty kind of mustard color. I'm gonna try to swatch these, but my hand is getting quite dirty from all the swatches I've been doing. It's a really nice mustard. I really like Melt's pencils. They're very creamy. This is the only one I own so far. I wouldn't hate to own more, but at the same time, I think they're $20 a pop, so not out here trying to spend a ton of money on eye pencils, especially when I have lots of beautiful ones from NYX. So let's talk about these now. The one I'm wearing in my waterline today is called Burnt Sienna. It's just a really pretty, just reddish brown. It's nothing that revolutionary, but at the same time, it's really pretty and perfect for these fall looks. Honestly, this entire Faux Blacks line from NYX is pretty perfect for fall. The next one that I have here in my hand is called, I think, Blackberry. Yes, Blackberry. It is a really deepened purple. Again, it's gonna go great with a lot of these palettes. This, I just picked kind of one of all the staples, mustard, brown, red kind of deal. This one is Oxblood. As you can see, it's teeny tiny because this was like my number one favorite pencil last autumn. I used the crap out of it. It's a really pretty, just deep red. Not so much brown as the Burnt Sienna one is. This one's just very dark red. It's really, really pretty. And finally, we have Black Olive, which as you might guess, it's a dark green. Let me get up close so you can kind of see these a little bit better, but just a nice little layout of fall tones. Nothing overly revolutionary, but I love colored eye pencils in my waterline. I do one with every single look, so I just picked a few staples that I think will complement pretty much all of these. Not to say I won't sway and use something else in my giant cup of eye pencils, but these I think are gonna be my favorites this time. And now we got lots of lip products to talk about. I actually don't have any glosses right now just because all of the gloss picks that I would pick for this are glosses that I wear all the time anyways. You know what I like, very sheer, sparkly gloss, plumping glosses, lip oils. I don't really wear colored lip glosses like this. Like, I wouldn't be out here wearing like a dark red gloss or a black gloss or a dark purple gloss. That's not really my vibe, so I didn't include any glosses in this because I didn't feel like I needed to be repetitive and talk about clear gloss because it's not really autumnal anyways. It's just something I personally like regardless of what time of year it is. I also want to mention, if you haven't seen it, I recommend checking out my top 10 favorite liquid lipsticks video because that entire color scheme is very autumnal and grungy. There are a couple repeats from that in this selection right here, but if you want like that entire selection as well, there's even more things over there for you. I think I have 12 if I counted correctly here in front of me. These are gonna be my absolute favorites this time of year and I'm excited to share them with you. This first one's from Milani. It's called Covet. I've loved this for years. I've probably had this particular lipstick like 4 years. It's just a really pretty warm chocolatey brown color. It's a very nice staple, just kind of neutral brown. For this time of year, it's gonna go with literally any autumnal look I do. I really like this Milani liquid lip formula. With every single liquid lip, I personally wear like a lip balm or a lip mask of some sort underneath because I don't like that incredibly drying feeling. I feel like having a lip balm underneath helps offset that and make it a little more comfortable. But all of these in and of itself are the most comfortable liquid lipsticks I've personally used, but just keep in mind I do wear a lip balm underneath everything. This next one is one I have not pulled out in a very long time, and when I was making my selections for this video, I decided to put this in it to help encourage myself to use it again. This one is one of the NYX Liquid Suedes in the shade Vintage. I think this will be such a nice pick with all of these palettes that I chose. It's a really pretty, just dark purpley red color. I don't really want to call it plum or maroon. I guess it's a little bit maroon though. It's really, really pretty. I'm excited to pull this one out. I like the liquid suedes because these stay kind of a creamy formula. These don't dry down completely. They're pretty comfortable. I like these. Haven't used one in a very long time though. I'm really excited to pull it out again. Next up from KVD Vegan Beauty, this is in the shade Plath. This was a discovery last month when they sent me a package and this was in it. I'm obsessed with it. It's the prettiest, just reddish brown color. I love it. I've worn this so many times already. I can't get enough of it. I know I'm going to be wearing this constantly this season. I just think it's perfect. It's going to go so nicely with everything that I pulled out today. Next up from Melt Cosmetics, this is in the shade Ginger. Such a good fall color if there ever was one. It's a really pretty, just warm orangey brown kind of color. It's super, super cute. I love Melt's liquid lipstick formula. Either this or Dose of Colors is my number one favorite. And this color is just so cute. I love the way it looks on my lips. I think it's so just pretty to look at. And again, it's gonna go so nicely with everything that I have today. A lot of these would even be really cute with just like maybe a winged liner and lashes, like nothing really on the eyes except just like liner, lashes, and then just a bold lip. What a cute look. I'm all about that. Let's move into Black Moon Cosmetics because all five that I own are in this list because I only own fall tones from them apparently. First is Sleepwalker, which is my number one favorite black liquid lipstick. You can't go wrong with a black lip, and I feel like especially this time of year almost feels the safest time to wear it. If you're someone who's scared of black lips, now's the time to try it because I feel like you can almost get away with it a little bit more. I do definitely get more funny looks if I wear a black lip in the spring or summer. Not that it stops me, but I feel like it like fits more this time of year. I don't know if that makes sense, but if you're scared of it, I recommend it. Black lips look good on everyone. I don't care what anyone has to say about that. Next is Purgatory. This is a really pretty dark purple. I love this one. Such a nice, just dark purple. I can't really say much more than that. It's really pretty. I love just how deep it is because it doesn't look overly purple in my opinion. It's just super dark and spooky, very cute. Next are the three that happen to be in the Harvest Trio from Black Moon. If you're interested in all three of these, I think you can buy them as a bundle, but you can also buy these individually. First up is Hazel, one of my longtime favorites. This is the prettiest olive green ever. Looks like that. So cute. I feel like I don't feel that weird when I wear this. It almost acts as a neutral for me, but maybe it's just because I'm not uncomfortable wearing an olive green lip. It goes with so many things. It would have complemented this look really nicely as well. I love this color. Next is Cider, this beautiful yellow. I almost wore this one today with this look, but I thought it might be too yellow with my shirt and my beanie, so I held off, but it's the most beautiful mustard yellow. Again, I kind of act like this is a neutral lip for me. It feels very normal to wear it. I never expected this to be a favorite when I initially picked it up. I thought it was a cool color, but I didn't think it was something I'd want to wear all the time, but it's one of my all-time favorite lipsticks. It's so pretty, and I get so many compliments when I wear it. And last from them is the one I'm wearing right now. It's called Harvest. I'll still swatch it just to complete this little line of swatches we have here, just so you can see those Harvest colors together. Such a perfect little trio. I really like this one. I feel like it's pretty bright, but also muted enough to where it feels very autumnal. I don't know. I know I'm repeating a lot of words. We're saying the words harvest, grunge, autumnal, fall so much in this video, but that's kind of the point, you know? I love this time of year. And finally, we just have three colors from Dose of Colors that I want to talk about with you. This first one is called Brick. It's a really pretty brick red color. Kind of brownish, kind of dark and reddish, really pretty. Again, it's gonna go with everything. I love this cohesive color story that's happening on my hand. Next up is Chocolate Wasted. You can't go wrong with a dark brown lip. You just can't. It's one of my favorites. This is another color that I feel like literally looks good on everyone. If you're scared of brown lips, you gotta try it because it's gonna look so good on you. one of my all-time favorite browns. It's so just rich and yummy, and again, goes with everything. Brown is really easy to wear too, because as long as you're on like the warmer side, like you're not wearing like maybe gray, it might not go with gray super well, but pretty much anything it's gonna go with. It looks so cute. And finally, Cork. This is one of my all-time favorite lipsticks. It's so pretty. It's just this really nice, just kind of warm, grungy brown color. It's so cute. I adore this one. I've worn it so many times. I'm pretty sure this is my second tube of it because I think I ran through my entire first one completely. But yeah, this is the lineup of my lipsticks. And that is it for the video. What did you think about my fall picks? Are you excited to go through your collection now and get out your fall picks? I would love to know what you think you'll be rocking a lot this autumn season. I'd love to know if you've tried any of the things I talk about, if you're interested in anything. I just want to hear all your thoughts. Tell me all about your favorite autumnal themed makeup. If you made it to the end of this video, leave me an emoji that relates to fall, whatever that means to you. And if you liked it, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. If you're not already, please hop over to my Instagram. It's Beaut Bean. Follow me there. I post every single day. And don't forget to subscribe. I'm posting most days here as well. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. Okay, bye.